Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about the Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. So these Thevenin's and Norton theorems are very important in solving the network problems having many active and passive elements. If the circuit is having so many elements, in that case the Thevenin's and Norton theorem help us to solve the numericals in a very easier way. So where it is used? Sometimes it is desirable to find out a particular branch current in a network when the resistance of that branch is varied while other resistances and sources remains constant. So the example is, let us take the example, I am taking one network. So in this network, my load resistance RL is a variable. So let us assume initially this load resistance RL is equal to 1 ohm. If I want to calculate the current through this branch, so current IL. So I can apply any one of the theorems discussed till now, I can calculate it. Let us assume now this resistance is varied to 2 ohms. So when this resistance is changed, so whatever calculations we make, that becomes invalid. Again, we have to make all the calculations. That means every time when the load is changing, automatically the load response, either the load voltage or the load current across this load is going to change. So which will become a tedious task. So if this can be simplified by a simple way, that means this entire circuit, which is contained up to this point, if this circuit can be replaced by some source in series with some resistance, like voltage source in series with resistance, or a current source in parallel with a resistance, like if it can be represented by a source, then it will be very easy to analyze. So there comes the idea of the Thevenin's theorem or the Norton's theorem. So the same thing I have discussed here. In the case of solving the network, so every time the time is consuming, so if it can be represented by some source in series with or source in parallel with the resistance, it will be very easy. So let us see what the Thevenin's has proposed. So Thevenin's theorem states that any two terminal linear bilateral network can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of a voltage source and series resistance seen into the network from the terminals. That means if you take one network, so in this network, this entire network, because inside there can be a sources, there can be active elements, passive elements, anything. So this entire network will be replaced by a voltage source in series with a resistance, and where this RL will be there, it will be easy to calculate. Where the value of VTH is given by VOC, which stands for open circuit voltage across these terminals A and B. That means when you remove the load, what will be the voltage that will appear across the terminals A and B, that is given by the VTH. And RTH is a Thevenin's resistance, which is the ratio of open circuit voltage and the short circuit current. So same thing is discussed. The equivalent voltage source VTH is the open circuit voltage between the terminals, and equivalent resistance RTH is the ratio of open circuit voltage to the short circuit current. So we have to calculate the open circuit voltage and short circuit these two terminals and calculate the current. And sometimes calculating these two is a tedious task. So there is one exception for this. There is an easy procedure if the some conditions are satisfied. That is, if the network doesn't have any dependent source, there are no dependent sources in your circuit, then RTH is nothing but RTH is the resistance seen from the terminals A and B when all the sources are replaced by their internal resistances. But whereas if you are having a dependent source, it cannot be represented by its internal resistance because it is a dependent source. In that case, there is no option. You have to go for RTH is equal to VOC by SC. But if you have independent source, this RTH is nothing but the open circuit resistance or the resistance seen from the terminals A and B. We will explain this with the help of an example so that it will be clarified. So let us take one example. Find the current through the resistance R of the figure. So R is a variable, but we are calculating the current at R is equal to 3 ohms. I don't know the value of R. The advantage of this Thevenin's theorem is, while calculating the elements or while representing the network, we need not have any idea about what is the load that is going to be connected. That means even though we don't know what is the load that is going to be connected, we can represent the remaining network in the form of a source in series with the resistance. That is the advantage of this. You can connect any value of resistance here and calculate there. Any load can be connected. So let us take this example and try to solve this. So you can observe from here, this circuit doesn't have any dependent source. So when there is no dependent source, calculation of RTH is very easy. Let us see how to calculate this. I have to replace each of my internal sources with their internal resistance. So 10 volt source is the ideal source, so 0, because nothing is mentioned here. Sometimes in numerical it will be mentioned that voltage comma this much resistance. That indicates the internal resistance. You have to replace with that internal resistance whenever you are calculating RTH. Remember this. So after this, this current source will be replaced by open circuit. and the 5 ohms is coming here. Current source is replaced by open circuit. So I want to calculate across these two terminals A and B. I am saving from here. I want to calculate RTH is equal to ROC. How to calculate this? You can see here this 5 ohms is in parallel to 10 ohms and the net is in series with 5 ohms. So this is 5 ohms in parallel with 10 ohms plus 5 ohms. So this becomes 5 into 10 by 15. 5 into 10 is 50 by 5 plus 10 is 15 plus 5. So if you calculate this, you will get this value as 8.33 ohms. So this much easy is to calculate ROC. So now let us see how to calculate my value of VTH. VTH is nothing but we have seen it is the open circuit voltage. So I am redrawing the circuit. So 10 volts. So there is 5 ohms, 10 ohms, 5 amperes, 5 ohms. Because VTH is nothing but the open circuit voltage. So I am open circuiting these terminals A and B. So I have to calculate this open circuit voltage or what is the voltage across these terminals VAB. This will become equal to VTH. So this I have to calculate. So let us try to calculate this. So it is having two sources, one voltage source and one current source. So if you want to calculate the voltage, I can apply my node voltage analysis or nodal analysis. If you apply the nodal analysis at this point, let us take this point name as C. So if you apply the nodal analysis at point C, so I can write 10 minus, because this point the voltage is 10, 10 minus VC divided by 5, 10 minus VC divided by 5 minus VC divided by 10, VC divided by 10, the current will go out, plus 5 amperes is entering. So the sum is equal to 0. So at this point, the current entering is equal to current leaving. I am taking current entering is because of this 10 volt source. So this is 10 minus VC by 5. And because of this VC, because these two are at same node. Remember here, this is also C because both are connected side by side. So this becomes VC by 10 plus 5 is equal to 0. I am taking this as my reference point. So from this, I can calculate my value of VC. VC is equal to 23.33 volts. So 23.33 volts is coming here. So here you can see the current passing through this resistance is 0 amperes because it is open circuited here. So whatever voltage comes at this point C, same voltage will come at point A. So this will be equal to my Thevenin equivalent resistance. So the entire equivalent circuit I can represent by plus minus, there is a voltage source is equal to 23.33 volts in series with 8.33 ohms. So this is coming to my terminals. This is my Thevenin's equivalent. So at this terminals you can connect any resistance. Let us assume I have connected a 3 ohms resistance. So in that case I want to calculate my current I. So how can I calculate the current I? This is nothing but a series circuit. So the current passing through the load is equal to voltage is 23.33 divided by total resistance is 8.33 plus 3. If you calculate, you will get it as 2.06 amperes. So this is my answer. So I am just writing here, this is 2.06 amperes. So I hope this is clear. So let us take one more case where there is a dependent source so that it will be completely clarified to you. So there is a dependent source here. You can see it is given by 0.5 times of I, where I is the current passing through branch which is connected between C and B. So in that case, how to calculate this? So I have told you before, whenever there is a dependent source, you cannot calculate the RTH directly. Only option available to you is calculate the value of ISC, calculate VTH, and RTH will be the ratio of VTH by ISC. That's why I am first calculating the value of VTH. So to calculate the VTH, VTH is nothing but because in this loop, whatever current is coming, this current will be equal to 0 because this is open circuit, because I want to calculate VTH or VOC when this is open circuit. So whatever is the voltage at this point, this voltage plus in series with this voltage. So that gives my resultant final value of VTH. So let us first calculate what is the voltage at this point. For that I have to calculate the current I, because I cannot calculate this 0.5I unless I know the value of I. So first I am calculating the value of I. How to calculate I? So because this circuit is removed, only circuit remaining is this much, because this is open circuit, because no current can pass in this circuit, current is 0. So automatically I is equal to this 5 divided by 2 plus 3, this becomes 1 ampere. So from this I can calculate my value of VC. VC is equal to 3 into 1 ampere is passing through this, so this becomes 3 volts. So I got the value of VC. So now you can apply the KVL in this loop. You can apply the KVL in this loop calculate. So in that way you can calculate this. So if you apply the KVL in this loop, you will get the value of VAB. VAB is equal to VC plus 0.5 times of I. So if you substitute the value of VC and substitute the value of I, you will get it as 3.5 volts, which is nothing but your VTH. Got it? So let us try to calculate the value of ISC. So to calculate the ISC, I have to short circuit there and calculate this value. Let us see how to calculate this. This is plus minus 2 ohms, 1 ohm, 3 ohms here, and it is given this is the value of I. This is 0.5 I, this point is given as C. So I want to short circuit my terminals A and B and calculate the current ISC. Calculate the current ISC. So now again same way I can use the nodal analysis to calculate the value of ISC. So this current is I, so this current is obviously, because if this is ISC, this current also will be equal to ISC. So I can calculate it easily. So applying the nodal analysis, I get 5 minus VC divided by 2 ohms. That gives the current that is coming in this way. Minus, because this is the current entering, minus current leaving is I, minus another current ISC. The current that will leave will be equal to 0.5 times of I plus VC divided by 1. This will be equal to 0. So from this, if you calculate the value, so you will get it. But here two variables are there. One is I and second one is VC. So we cannot directly solve it. So let us see what are the other variables which are available. So other variables I can calculate. I can calculate my value of I in terms of VC. So I can calculate my value of I is equal to VC divided by 3. So this is my equation number 2. This is my equation number 1. So you can simplify these two equations to get the answer. If you simplify these equations, you will get the value of VC is equal to 1.25 volts, and from that I can calculate my value of ISC is VC plus 0.5 times of I. I is nothing but VC by 3. So if you substitute it, you will get at 1.458 amperes. So once you get the value of ISC and VSC, I can calculate my value of RTH. RTH is nothing but VOC divided by ISC. So if you substitute, you will get it as 2.4 ohms. So this entire circuit I can replace like this. So this circuit will have a voltage source of 3.5 volts in series with 2.4 ohms. These are my terminals A and B. This is my Thevenin's equivalent. Getting it? So I am going little bit fast because I know that till now already you have practiced so many numericals and you know how to solve the things easily. Because I don't want to go slowly so that it will be boring for you. So that's why I am going fast. If you feel that I am going little bit fast or you want me to teach slow, you can leave your comments in comment section below. I will take care for the coming lectures. Now coming to the Norton's theorem. So Norton's theorem is just the converse to the Thevenin's theorem. Only difference between Thevenin's and the Norton's theorem is, in Thevenin's theorem we are representing by a voltage source in series with a resistance. Whereas in the case of Norton theorem, we represent the current source in parallel with a resistance. That means instead of voltage source, I am representing with current source. Only that is the basic difference between these two. And the statement of this theorem is, any two terminal linear bilateral network can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of a current source in parallel with resistance seen from the terminals. That means any network, if you take, this network can be represented by a current source in parallel with the voltage source. This current source is the Norton equivalent current and resistance is Norton equivalent resistance. They are represented by I suffix n and R suffix n. So how to calculate this? The equivalent current source IN is the short circuit current between the terminals, and equivalent resistance RN is the ratio of open circuit voltage to the short circuit current at the terminals. So this statement, when you see, you will feel that this is something similar to the Thevenin's only. So let us try to prove that Thevenin's and Norton's are one and the same. Only difference is in representation. So the Norton theorem tells that this IN is equal to ISC and the value of RN is VOC divided by ISC. VOC divided by ISC. Because we know VOC divided by ISC is nothing but my Thevenin's equivalent resistance only. So let us try to correlate between the Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. We know the Thevenin's equivalent voltage is nothing but open circuit voltage at the terminals. So I am just dividing and multiplying with ISC. So if I divide and multiply with ISC, we know the ratio of VOC by ISC. VOC by ISC by the definition of Norton theorem is nothing but the Norton equivalent resistance RN. And this ISC is nothing but the Norton equivalent current. So you can tell that VTH is equal to Norton resistance multiplied by Norton current. Or I can tell that the Norton current IN is equal to VTH divided by RTH, because from this equation. Or this is nothing but, you will see that it is something like a source transformation. Source transformation, in source transformation we have seen that a voltage source in series with resistance can be replaced by current source in parallel with resistance, where current will be equal to that voltage divided by resistance. So same thing is obtained here. So that's why I can tell that both are dual to each other. Now let us try to take some example and try to solve this. I am taking the single example which will clarify all the things, which is having a dependent source, so that everything will be clarified. So determine the values of I and R in the circuit, where it is given like this. One circuit is given, it is drawn, this is equivalent to I in parallel with R. This indicates you have to calculate the Norton equivalent. So for calculating the Norton equivalent, I need two things. One is the calculation of ISC and the second one is RTH. So whenever dependent source is there, RTH cannot be found easily. So only option is you have to go for open circuit voltage divided by short circuit current. That means in this circuit, I have to calculate the value of ISC as well as the value of VTH or VOC. Both Thevenin's and Norton's we are applying for calculating the resistance. So let us try to first calculate the value of ISC. So I am just drawing the circuit once again. This is my 1 ampere source. There is 10 ohms. There is 8 ohms. So 2i, 3 ohms, 4 ohms. So to calculate ISC, I have to short circuit this X and Y. So let us assume this is my value of ISC. ISC is the current passing from X to Y. So now let us try to summarize the values at different points. So this is 1 ampere. So here the current is coming is 2i. Sorry, I forget to keep here. This is already given as I. So from this I can calculate what is the current passing through this. You apply the KCL at this node. If you apply the KCL, you will get it as I plus 1. Similarly here, one current is going like this, 2i. And this current is ISC. So what will be the current passing through this 3 ohms? If you calculate, again applying the KVL, I will get 1 minus I minus ISC. This is the value of current that is passing. So now I am taking the two loops. This is loop 1 and this is my loop 2. Loop 1 and loop 2. I am just applying the KVL in these loops. So when I am applying to loop 1, so you will get this as minus 10 times of I plus 1. I am just applying the mesh, because in each loop I am just finding the values. I am just applying the KVL. So minus 3 times of 1 minus I minus ISC. Then in the current 8 ohms, I am going opposite to the direction. So this becomes 8 times of I is equal to 0. So or this can be simplified as I plus 3 times of ISC is equal to 13. This is equation number 1. Similarly, I can apply in loop number 2. So if you apply in loop number 2, you will get it as minus 4 times of ISC, and through 3 ohms I am going in opposite direction. So this becomes 3 into 1 minus I minus ISC is equal to 0. Or from this I can simplify, 3i plus 7 times of ISC is equal to 3. So I have 2 unknowns and I got 2 equations. So I can solve them. So if you solve them for getting the value of ISC, so I will get my value of ISC is equal to 18 amperes. So I got my ISC. So now I want to calculate my value of VOC. open circuit voltage, because to calculate the RTH. So calculate the open circuit voltage, again same thing, I am drawing my circuit again. So this circuit is having 1 ampere, there is some resistance of 10 ohms, here there is 8 ohms resistance, through 8 ohms resistance it is given I, there is a dependent current source which is given by 2I, there is one 3 ohm resistance, there is one 4 ohm resistance, and these are my terminals X and Y. I want to calculate by value of VOC. As this is open circuit, what will be the current passing through this? This will be 0. So let us try to calculate the remaining currents. So again you can apply the currents here. This is 1 ampere is coming here. This is I. So here 2I is coming. So out of 2I, I is going here, 1 ampere is here. So this becomes automatically I plus 1. This is passing at this point. Now through 3 ohms resistance, again same thing, this current is 0, this current is 2I. So automatically this current I can calculate as 1 minus I. 1 minus I. Again take the two loops. So in these loops you can apply the KVL. So if you apply in this loop, first loop will get minus 10 into I plus 1. Then in 3 also I am going in same direction. So 3 into 1 minus I. And 8 I am going in opposite direction to the current direction. So automatically this becomes plus 8 into I is equal to 0. So if you substitute, if you simplify this, you will get the value of I is equal to 13 amperes. So now if you apply to loop number 2, if you apply to loop number 2, you will get this value of VOC. VOC is equal to, through 4 ohms the current is 0, so anyway that will be cancelled. So this will become 3 times of 1 minus I. We know the value of I, just substitute the value of I here, you will get this value as 36 volts. So remember here you are getting the negative voltage. So from this I can calculate my value of RTH or RN is equal to VOC divided by ISC. So this is minus 36 divided by 18, it is coming minus 2 ohms. So you can see here, if you are calculating the resistance, you are getting the negative value. So the meaning of the negative value means, whatever the current direction you are assuming, that current direction is not correct. It is actually opposite direction. So if you want to represent this in the form of Norton equivalent, because it is already asked there. So it is given like this. Though I have to calculate my value of X and Y. So automatically this resistance we got is equal to 2 ohms, because resistance will always be positive. The current direction we have taken what they have given, but that is wrong. So this current direction in this direction will be equal to minus 18 amperes. We got 18 amperes, but actually it is minus 18 amperes, so that actually the current is passing like this through the resistor, and the drop will be minus plus here. So you will get this output VOC voltage as negative. Remember this. I hope all these things are clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries there. Or else, if you feel that some numerical you were not able to solve properly using any one of these analysis, you can send to my email. My email ID is ktraju@gmail.com. I am repeating again, my email ID is ktraju@gmail.com. So thank you very much.